Howdy folks! So, if you haven't seen my last playthrough of Undertale, basically I got a neutral ending because I didn't fulfill all the requirements to meet a pacifist ending and because I'd never played the game before. But I had done almost everything right to get a pacifist ending, so all I had to do was a little bit more to make it a pacifist ending. So, here's me doing the last little adjustments to get the good ending. Hope you enjoy.
Oh, wow. So, when I was at this part a long, long time ago, I basically had done everything except talk to him at the end. I forgot to talk to him in this room. So now I know where to go. Begin the date? Of course. Okay, dating. Start. Dating? Why is it a fight?
Here we are on our date. I've actually never done this before. But don't worry, you can't spell prepared without several letters from my name. I snagged an official dating rulebook from the library. We're ready to have a great time! Let's, step one. Press the
C key for your dating HUD.
Wowee! I feel so informed!
Crime. Thursday. Reel it in. Population. Egg.
I think we're ready for step two. Step two. Ask them out on a date. Ahem. Human! I, the Great Papyrus, will go on a date with you!
Okay.
Really? Wowie!
I guess that means it's time for part three! Step three, put on nice clothes to show you care.
Wait a second. Wear clothing! That locket around your neck. You're wearing clothing right now! Not only that, earlier today, you were also wearing clothing. No! Could it be? You've wanted to date me from the very beginning!
Sure.
No! You planned it all!
He has eyeballs.
You're way better at dating than I am! No! You're dating power!
What is happening?
Yeah.
Don't think you've bested me yet. Tension.
I, the Great Papyrus, I've never been beaten at dating, and I never will. I can easily keep up with you. You see, I too can wear clothing. In fact, I always wear my special clothes under my regular clothes, just in case somebody happens to ask me on a date. Behold! Yeah, what do you think of my secret style?
I love it.
No! A genuine compliment!
What is happening? I'm on a date with the skeleton. I am so confused.
However, you don't truly understand the hidden power of this outfit. Therefore, what you just said is invalid. This date won't escalate any further unless you find my secret, but that won't happen. Human souls are stronger than monster souls, but the soles of our shoes, on the other hand, are about the same.
Check out the socks.
There's no secret to my legs, just hard work and perseverance.
There's no secret to my legs? Okay, that's legs again.
This shirt didn't originally say cool, but I improved it. Expert tip, all clothing articles can be improved this way.
I see. You like caressing my biceps with a floating heart. But who doesn't? What about your gloves?
Holding my hand, so I'll tell you the answer. No, I must resist. My hat! Well then, you found my secret. I suppose I have no choice. It's a present. A present just for you.
Open.
Do you know what this is?
It's spaghetti.
Spaghetti.
That's what you're thinking, isn't it?
Right! But oh, so wrong! This ain't any plain old pasta. This is an artisan's work.
Silken spaghetti, finely aged in an oaken cask. Then cooked by me, Master Chef Papyrus.
Human, it's time to end this. There's no way this can go any further.
I take a small bite. My face reflexively, the taste is indescribable.
What a passionate expression! You must really love my cooking. And by extension, me. Maybe even more than I do. Ah! Ah! No!
What just happened?
Human, it's clear now. You're madly in love with me. Everything you do, everything you say, it's all been for my sake. Human, I want you to be happy too. It's time for me to express my feelings. It's time I told you. I, Papyrus. I, boy, this is hot in here. Or is it just me? Oh, shoot. Human, I'm sorry. I don't like you the way you like me. Romantically, I mean, I tried very hard to. I thought that because you flirted with me, that I was supposed to go on a date with you. Then, on the date, feelings would blossom forth. I would be able to match your passion for me. But, alas, I, the great Papyrus, have failed. I feel just the same as before. And instead, by dating you, I have only drawn you deeper into your intense love for me! A dark prison of passion with no escape.
Why do I sound like Bane? I just noticed that. This isn't the same voice I was doing before, is it? Before I was doing like a male Bertina. Now I'm doing like Bane. I don't know why. I'm just trying to be quieter now because like family are around and sleeping. Anyway.
A dark prison of passion with no escape. How could I have done this to my dear friend? No, wait! That's wrong! I can't fail at anything! Human, I'll help you through these trying times. I'll keep being your cool friend and act like this all never happened. After all, you are very great. It would be tragic to lose your friendship. So please, don't cry because I won't...
Okay, I won't cry.
Because I don't even have lips. And hey, someday you'll find someone as great as me. Well, no, that's not true. But I'll help you settle for second best. Oh yeah, and if you ever need to reach me, here's my phone number. You can call me anytime, platonically. Well, gotta go.
Cool. Well, that happened. Let's go talk to Sans. I guess the door is probably still locked. Aha! I have found Undyne's house. What? 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 It's a living. Oh.
Oh-ho! The human arrives! Are you ready to hang out with Undyne? I have a plan to make you two great friends.
Will you hang out? Yes, of course.
Okay, stand behind me! Psst. Make sure to give her this. She loves these.
Okay. Whoa.
Hi, Papyrus. Ready for your extra private one-on-one training? You bet I am, and I brought a friend.
Hi, I don't think we've... Why don't you two come in? Okay.
Here, Undyne, my friend brought a gift for you, on their own.
Thanks. I'll, put it with the others. So, are we ready to start?
Whoopsie doopsie, I just remembered. I have to go to the bathroom. You two have fun.
What?
So why are you here? To rub your victory in my face? To humiliate me even further? Is that it?
No.
Then why are you here? Wait, I get it. You think that I'm gonna be friends with you, huh? Right?
Yeah?
Really? How delightful. I accept.
Oh, well. Let's all frolic in the fields of friendship.
Not. Why would I ever be friends with you? If you weren't my houseguest, I'd beat you up right now. You're the enemy of everyone's hopes and dreams. I will never be your friend. Now get out of my house.
Dang, what a shame. I thought Undyne could be friends with you, but I guess I overestimated her. She's just not up to the challenge.
Challenge? What?
Papyrus!
I almost said Papyrus's voice.
Papyrus, wait a second.
Darn it. He thinks I can't be friends with you? Ha, what a joke. I could make friends with a wimpy loser like you any day. I'll show him.
Listen up, human. We're not just going to be friends. We're going to be... besties.
I'll make you like me so much, you won't be able to think of anyone else. It's the perfect revenge. Why don't you have a seat? Okay. Do I want to look around first? Hopefully she won't get mad. I can't believe he leapt through the window like that. Normally he nails the landing. One time, Alfie's friend came over here. All he did was lie seductively on the piano and fed himself grapes. I don't really like that guy, but I admire his lifestyle. Oh, wow. In the sink is a teacup in the shape of a fish. This oven is the top of the line MTT thing, but you know, as much as technology advances, nothing beats food home cook with fire magic. There's a silverware drawer. It has forks, spoons, knives, those tiny swords, axes, spears, nunchucks. That's funny. I hate cold food, so Alfie's fixed my fridge so it heats up food instead. Hot fridge, the world's greatest invention! Humans suck, but their history kinda rules. Case in point, this giant sword! Historically, humans wielded swords up to 10 times their size. Right? I don't think that's entirely true, but sure. Heh, I knew it! When I first heard that, I immediately wanted one. So me and Alfie's built a giant sword together. She figured out all the specs herself. She's smart, huh? She is pretty smart. Oh, I can't get by you. Alright, let me sit down and progress. Unless I can talk to you? It's so nice to have you over. Why not take a seat at the table? Alright. Comfortable? I'll get you something to drink. This is funny. Wow. All set. What would you like? Oh my gosh. Hey! Don't get up! You're the guest! Sit down and enjoy yourself! Why not just point to what you want? You can use the spear. Aim with arrows and select with Z. Aim at her! What if I did aim at her? Undyne, select with Z. Sugar goes in tea. Soda, sickly yellow liquid. Hot chocolate, green cylinder. Green cylinder? It doesn't look green, it looks blue. Tea box, blatantly correct choice. Select with Z. Okay. Fridge, full of food. Sword, acquired taste. I can't aim any further. I would choose something random just for fun, but I don't want to mess it up. Tea, huh? Coming right up! It'll take a moment for the water to boil. Alright, what about that fire magic? Okay, it's all done. Here we are. Careful, it's hot. I still have a spear in my hands. It's not that hot, just drink it already. It's burning. But other than that, it's pretty good. It's pretty good, right? Yeah, why would I not say that? Nothing but the best for my absolutely precious friend! Wow. Hey, you know, it's kind of strange that you chose that tea. Golden flower tea. That's Asgore's favorite kind. Actually, now that I think about it, you kind of remind me of him. You're both total weenies. Sort of. That's funny. You know, I was a pretty hot-headed kid. Once, to prove I was the strongest, I tried to fight Asgore. Emphasis on tried. I couldn't land a single blow on him. And worse, the whole time, he refused to fight back. I was so humiliated. Afterwards, he apologized and said something goofy. Excuse me, do you want to know how to beat me? I said yes, and from there, he trained me. One day, during practice, I finally knocked him down. I felt bad. But he was beaming. I had never seen someone more proud to get their butt kicked. Anyway, long story short, he kept training me. And now I'm the head of the Royal Guard. So I'm the one who gets to train dorks to fight. Like, Papyrus. That's funny. But, to be honest, I don't know if I can ever let Papyrus into the Royal Guard. Don't tell him I said that. He's just, well, I mean, it's not that he's weak. He's actually pretty freaking tough. It's just that he's too innocent and nice. I mean, look, he was supposed to capture you, and he ended up being friends with you instead. I could never send him into battle. He'd get ripped into little smiling shreds. That's part of why I started teaching him how to cook, you know? So, maybe he could do something else with his life. Oh, sorry, I was talking for so long. You're out of tea, aren't you? I'll get you some more. Wait a second. Papyrus, his cooking lessons. He was supposed to have that right now! And if he's not here to have it, you'll have to take it for him! Is this a battle? That's right! Nothing has brought Papyrus and I closer than cooking! Which means that if I give you his lesson, we'll become closer than you could ever imagine! This is like... Afraid? We're gonna be best friends. It's so intimidating. The friendship of... Oh my gosh. I just got picked up by the hair and was sticking straight out. Wow, not sagging at all. Let's start with the sauce. Oh my gosh. Envision these vegetables as your greatest enemy. Now, pound them to dust with your fists. How will you pound? Strong. I knock over a tomato. Yeah! Yeah! Our hearts are uniting against these healthy ingredients. Now it's my turn. We'll just scrape this into a bowl later. But for now... She can knock anything down from the ceiling. We had the noodles! Homemade noodles are the best! But I just buy store brand! They're the cheapest! Yeah! Just put them in the pot. How will you put them in?
Fiercely.
Careful. I place them in one at a time. They clank against the empty bottom. Nice! Alright, now it's time to stir the pasta. As a general rule of thumb, the more you stir, the better it is! Ready? Let's do it! Z! Stir harder! I am stirring harder! Harder!
Harder!
I'm doing it as hard as I can. Ugh, let me do it. You just killed your pot. That's the stuff! Alright, now for the final step.
Turn up the heat! Turn up the heat!
Alright.
Let your hopes and dreams burn into the burning fire! Ready? Don't hold anything back!
Hold right to turn up the heat.
Ooh! Hotter! Hotter! Darn it! Hotter!
Oh my gosh. Wait, that's too... Did I just burn down her house? Oh no. Ah! Man, no wonder Papyrus sucks at cooking. do you need help putting out your house? So what's next? Scrapbooking? Friendship bracelets? Oh, who am I kidding? I really screwed this up, didn't I? I can't force you to like me, human. Some people just don't get along with each other. I understand if you feel that way about me. And if we can't be friends, that's okay. Because if we're not friends...
It means I can destroy you without regret!
I've been defeated. My house is in shambles. Oh no. I even failed to befriend you. That's it. I don't care if you're my guest anymore. One final rematch. All out on both sides. It's the only way I can regain my lost pride. Now come on, hit me with all you've got.
Yeah.
Fake attack? I pretend to swing at Undyne with all my might. What? That's the best you can manage? Even attacking at full force? You just can't muster any intent to hurt me, huh? Heh. You know what? I don't actually want to hurt you either. At first, I hated your stupid saccharine shtick, but the way you hit me right now, it reminded me of someone I used to train with. Now I know you aren't just some wimpy loser. You're a wimpy loser with a big heart, just like him. Listen, human, it seems that you and Asgore are fated to fight. But knowing him, he probably doesn't want to. Talk to him. I'm sure you can persuade him to let you go home. Eventually, some mean human will fall down here, and I'll take their soul instead. That makes sense, right? Foo-hoo-hoo. Oh, and if you do hurt Asgore, I'll take the human souls, cross the barrier, and beat the heck out of you. That's what friends are for, right? Foo-hoo-hoo-hoo. Now let's get the heck out of this flaming house. Or we could put it out. Well, that wasn't fun, huh? We'll have to hang out again for another time. But, somewhere else, I guess. In the meantime, I guess I'll go hang out with Papyrus. So if you need me, drop by Snowden, okay? Oh, and if you ever need help, just give Papyrus a ring, okay? Since we're in the same spot, I'll be able to talk too. Well, see you later, punk. Oh, wait! This is sudden, but, can you... Hey, wait. Your inventory's full. Well, I'll be at Papyrus's. Come see me when you have less stuff. Okay, I'll just drop one of the things that I have. I'll put it in a box, I guess. I still can't believe I was so close to finishing the date with Papyrus, but I didn't talk to him, and that's the last thing I needed to do.
It seems Undyne has something for you. She's the person. That's not me.
So I have a favor to ask you. I need you to deliver this letter to Dr. Alpheus. What? Why don't I do it myself? Well, it's kind of personal, but we're friends, so I'll tell you. Hotland sucks. I don't want to have to go over there. So here you go. I got Undyne's letter. Oh, and if you read it, I'll kill you. Thanks so much. You're the best. Alright, sounds good. So, what are you waiting for? The sooner you get it over with, the better.
Undyne writes a lot of letters, but she can never seem to find the right words, so when she goes to deliver them herself, she always quits so she can go back and rewrite. That's why she asked you, because you have no standards.
Okay, well, I guess I'll, sail over to Hotland then and deliver the letter.
No, no, not waterfall. Ah,
I wish there was a way to skip this. I don't want to go there. Tra-la-la, I heard spiders have a favorite food. It's spiders. Oh, come again sometime. Like, right now? Tra-la-la, care for a ride. Yes, ride in the boat. Hotland. There we go. The door has no mail slot. Slide the letter under? Sure. Oh no, is that another letter? I don't want to open it. Can't I just slide it back out? I can't keep doing this. I'll read this one. It's shut kind of strongly, isn't it? Wait a second. What is happening? Hey, if this is a joke, it's... Oh my gosh? Did you write this letter? It wasn't signed, so I had no idea who it could have... Oh my gosh, oh no, that's adorable. And I had no idea you, wrote that way. It's surprising, too, after all the gross stuff I did. I don't really deserve to be forgiven, much less, this? And so passionately, too. You know what? Okay, I'll do it. It's the least I can do to make it up to you. Yeah, let's go on a date. No, why can't I just explain that it's from Undyne? What? Dating. Start. Am I supposed to press C? Sorry. I'm still getting requests. Okay. How do I look? I'm not gonna comment on that. My friend helped me pick out this dress. You had a friend in that lab? She's got a great sense of... anyway, let's do this thing. Hey, wait! Actually, we still can't start the date yet. Dating stop? I've gotta give you items to raise your affection statistic first. That'll increase the chance of a successful outcome to the date, right?
Anyway, don't worry, I'm prepared. I've been stockpiling gifts in anticipation for a date like this. First, I've got some metal armor polish. Maybe you can't use that. But I also brought some waterproof cream for your scales. Well, how about this magical spear repair kit that I... Hey, let's forget about the items. Let's just start the date. Yeah, let's, date. I don't think either of us know what to do. What button am I supposed to press again? I forget. Do you... like... anime? Not really, to be honest. I apologize. Oh. Hey, let's go somewhere. But where's a good place to go on a date? Papyrus's house, so we can see Undyne, so you can explain to her. Because apparently I can't speak. I've got it! Let's go to the garbage dump! Alright. Here we are! This is where Undyne and I come all the time. We find all sorts of great stuff here. Heh, she's really... Oh no. That's her over there. I can't let her see me on a date with you. Why? Because, well... Oh no, here she comes! Hey, there you are! I realized that if you deliver that thing, it might be a bad idea. So I'm gonna do it. Give it to me! Huh? You don't have it? Nah! Have you at least seen her? Yes? So she's somewhere around here. Thanks, I'll keep looking. Oh my gosh. Well, I guess it's obvious, huh? I really like her. I mean, more than I like other people. I'm sorry. I just figured, you know, it'd be fun to go on, like, a cute kind of pretend date with you to make you feel better. Well, it sounds even worse when I put it like that. I'm sorry, I messed up again. Undyne's the person I really want to go on a date with. But I mean, she's way out of my league. Not that you aren't. I mean, cool. But Undyne, she's so confident and strong and funny, and I'm just a nobody. A fraud. I'm the royal scientist, but all I've ever done is hurt people. I've told her so many lies, she thinks I'm a lot cooler than I actually am. If she gets close to me, she'll find out the truth about me. You're pretty cool. You hacked things. The truth? But if I tell her that, she'll hate me. Isn't it better this way? To live a lie where both people are happy? Or a truth where neither of us are? They say be yourself, but I don't really like who myself is. I'd rather just be whatever makes people like me. No, you're right. Every day I'm scared. Scared of what will happen if people learn the truth on their own. They'll all get hurt because of me. But how can I tell Undyne the truth? I don't have the confidence. I'm gonna mess it up. How can I practice? Obviously, let's roleplay it. Roleplay? That actually sounds kind of fun. Okay, which one of us will be Undyne? I'll be Undyne. Oh, right, obviously. Ahem. Hi, Undyne, how are you doing today? I'm fine, you're cute. Haha, glad to hear it. So I'd like to talk to you about something. What is... Then she kisses you. The heck? What is it, Alpheus? You see, I haven't been exactly truthful with you. You see, I... Oh, forget it. Undyne, I want to tell you how I feel. You're so brave and strong and nice. You always listen to me when I talk about nerdy stuff. You always do your best to make me feel special. Like telling me that you'll beat up anyone that gets in my way. Undyne! I can't take this any longer! I'm not in love with you! Hold me, Undyne! Hold me! Oh my gosh. What did he just say? Undyne! I was just... Hey, whoa, wait a second. Your outfit's really cute. What's the occasion? Wait a second. Are you two on a date? Yes? I mean, no? I mean, we were... But, I mean, actually, we were...
What? I've been lying to you. What? About what?
About, well, everything. I told you that the seaweed was, like, scientifically important. Really, I used to make ice cream. And those human history books, blah, 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 dorky comic books, and the history movies, those are just, anime. They aren't real. And that time I told you I was busy with work on the phone, I was just eating frozen yogurt in my pajamas. Alfies? Calm yourself. I wanted to impress you. I just wanted you to think I was smart and cool. That I wasn't some nerdy loser. Alfies, Undyne, I really think you're neat, okay? Alfies, shh. Shh. What is going on? Alfies! I think you're neat, too, I guess. But you've gotta realize, most of what you said really doesn't matter to me. I don't care if you're watching kid cartoons or reading history books. To me, all of that stuff is just nerdy crap. What I like about you is that you're passionate. You're analytical. It doesn't matter what it is. You care about it. 100%, at maximum power. So, you don't have to lie to me. I don't want you to have to lie to anyone anymore. Alfies, I want to help you become happy with who you are. And I do know just the training you need to do with that. Undyne, you're gonna train me? What? Me? Nah, I'm gonna get Papyrus to do it. Get those bones shaking. It's time to jog 100 laps, hooting about how great we are. Ready? I'm about to start the timer. Undyne, I'll do my best. Oh my gosh! She was kidding, right? Those cartoons, those comics. Those are still real, right? Anime's real, right? Anime is not real. No! No! I can feel my heart breaking into pieces! No, I can survive this. I have to be strong, for Alfies. Thank you, human, for telling me the truth. I'll try my best to live in this world. See you later! What just happened? All of that. Just, what? Did I not get a single moment free to explain to Alfies that that letter was from Undyne and... Oh my gosh, I don't even know what just happened. Well, that was crazy.
Howdy! If it isn't my good friend, who trusts me? This is Papyrus. You're also a mutual friend. Alfies and I just finished our training early. Very early. So I sent her home. Very home. Now, I feel strongly, and for no apparent reason, you should also go there. To her lab house. I have only good feelings about this. Goodbye.
Okay.
Let's go there. Whoa, what did he say? Something about his pants taking off on Friday? I'm confused. This is fun. I've basically done all the hard work parts of it, and now I'm just, like, getting to do all the story all together. It's fun. Alright, so I am here. Where are people? Note. It's a note from Alfies. Read it? Sure. It's hard to read because of the handwriting, but you tried my best. Hey, thanks for your help back there. You guys, your support really means a lot to me. But as difficult it is to say that, you guys alone can't magically make my problems go away. I want to be a better person, and I don't want to be afraid anymore. And for that to happen, I have to be able to face my own mistakes. I'm going to start doing that now. I want to be clear. This isn't anyone else's problem but mine. But if you don't ever hear from me again, if you want to know the truth, enter the door to the north of this note. You all at least deserve to know what I did. That's all she wrote. So this is an elevator, not a bathroom. I thought it was a bathroom. Warning! Warning! Elevator losing power! Oh dear. M tether stability loss. Altitude dropping. Oh my gosh, what is happening? Okay! What is this? Entry number 1. This is it. Time to do what the king has asked me to do. I will create the power to free us all. I will unleash the power of the soul. Entry number 2. The barrier is locked by soul power. Unfortunately, this power cannot be created artificially. Soul power can only be derived from what was once living. So, to create more, we will have to use what we have now. The souls of monsters. Okay. Entry number 3. But extracting a soul from a living monster would require incredible power. Besides being impractical, doing so would instantly destroy the soul's host. And, unlike the persistent souls of humans, the souls of most monsters disappear immediately upon death. If only I could make a monster's soul last. Entry number 4. 5. I've done it. Using the blueprints, I've extracted it from the human souls. I believe this is what gives their souls the strength to persist after death. The will to keep living, the resolve to change fate. Let's call this power determination. So he extracted determination from human souls. Or something. It's a fake plant. Power room. What's over here? Entry number 6. Asgore asked everyone outside the city for monsters that had fallen down. Their bodies came in today. They're still comatose, and soon they'll all turn into dust. But what happens if I inject determination into them? If their souls persist after they perish, then freedom might be closer than we all thought. Entry number 9. Things aren't going well. None of the bodies have turned into dust, so I can't get the souls. I told the families that I would give them the dust back for the funerals. People are starting to ask me what's happening. What do I do? Are these people stuck in stasis? It's some kind of operating table. It's sticky. Oh. Ooh, what is this? Oh man. What the? Okay. Dot drew near. Come join the fun. Oh gosh, what is this? But nobody came. Memory head, eh? That's a shame. Become one of us. Seems like it doesn't care anymore. I won. Yay, what is this? There's a red key lying in the sink. I took it and put it in your keychain. There's a note on the ground. I can't make it all out. Drain. Dropped it. That's all I could read. Click. The red key fits perfectly into the slot. So now what? Oh, I see. I need to complete a bunch of different more switches. Entry number 12. Nothing is happening. I don't know what to do. I'll just keep injecting everything with determination. I want this to work. Entry number 13. One of the bodies opened its eyes. Oh. It's an empty dog food bowl. Seems like a comfortable bed. Lie on it? No, thank you. It's a bed. It's a bed. I'm not getting any options to lie on this one. What happens if I lie on it? Why would I want to, though? I mean, I have saved, so if something bad happens, then I could reload. Entry number 14. Everyone that had fallen down has woken up. They're all walking around and talking like nothing is wrong. I thought they were goners? But now they have determination to succeed. Entry number 15. Seems like this research was a dead end, but at least we got a happy ending out of it. I sent the souls back to Asgore, returned the vessel to his garden, and I called all the families and told them everyone's alive. I'll send everyone back tomorrow. Awesome. People got saved. Well, not in a spiritual sense, in a literal sense. Entry number 16. No. Just no. That's all? What happened? Oh my. Okay, I'll go in here first. What is this? Why am I in slow motion? Hi? Oh, horror. And then a monster attacks? There was nothing in there. That was for nothing. Okay, I don't know what that was. Something's in the drain, though, I think. Okay, that was not a safe point. What was that? Smells like sweet lemons. Lemon bread. Scream. Cry. Welcome to my special hell. Okay. Ow. Ow. Okay. Do you think I'm pretty? Hug? Unhug. Scream. Oh, hum. That's what they all say. I didn't see where to go. That's what they all say. That took a long time because there were a bunch of options and I tried every single one except the one I was supposed to, apparently. Malibu. Thank you. Entry number 4. I've been researching humans to see if I can find any info about their souls. I ended up snooping around the castle and found these weird tapes. I don't feel like Asgore's watched them. I don't think he should. This is so confusing. It's like an insight into my past life or something? DT extraction machine, status inactive. Determination extraction? Okay, what's going on here? What is this room? Is this just a foggy haze for no reason? Oh, there's something up here, isn't there? It's too dark to see in there. Entry number 11. Now that Mediton's made it big, he never talks to me anymore, except to ask when I'm going to finish his body. But I'm afraid if I finish his body, he won't need me anymore. Then we'll never be friends ever again. Not to mention, every time I try to work on it, I just get really sweaty. What are these things? Fans? Well, there's a switch on the wall. Press it? Yes. Gotcha. So it blows away all the fog. Oh, and creates the thing. Hello, thing. Oh, what is that? Hello. It's the amalgamate. Amalgamate? If I had anything that I could use to heal, I would use it. But I can't. Play, beckon, ignore, beckon. Amalgam is hovering close, looking for affection. Affection? Okay. Should've brought some snacks. This music's really creepy. What do I need to do to it now? It's already affectionate. I've already played with it, I've already beckoned it. How about I ignore it? Cool. I don't know what just happened. But now hopefully the smoke's gone in the other end of the hall. Is this just gonna give me some extra... Wait, what was that? Aha. I knew there was something. I saw it. What is this? Is it going to poke me? Should I not let it touch me? Should I let it touch me? Huh? Huh. It covered me up. Am I sleeping? What am I doing here? Okay, interesting. Oh, are these... Oh... Are these creatures... Hang on, I'm gonna go in here and check out what's this. Are these weird ghostly creature things that I keep running into, are they the monsters that were given determination to stay alive even though they should have died? Entry number 7. We'll need a vessel to wield the monster souls when the time comes. After all, a monster cannot absorb the souls of other monsters. Just as a human cannot absorb a human soul. So then, what about something that's neither human nor monster? Like a golden flower. Uh-oh. Entry number 10. Experiments on the vessel are a failure. It doesn't seem to be any different from the control cases. Whatever. They're a hassle to work with anyway. The seeds just stick to you and won't let go. Hello, self. Okay, what's this? Hi. I don't know what you are. Mystify, hum, clean, pray, let's do clean. Nothing happened. I can't read what you're saying. What is going on? Oh gosh, I don't know what's happening. But it was already mystified. This last look. Oh gosh. Something afraid of? Finally, someone gets it. Ribbit, ribbit, courage. Entry number 19. The families keep calling me to ask when everyone is coming home. What am I supposed to say? I don't even answer the phone anymore. It's a refrigerator. It's empty. It's a refrigerator. It seems to contain samples of some kind. Entry number 20. Asgore left me 5 messages today. 4 about everyone being angry. 1 about this cute little teacup you found that looks like me. Thanks, Asgore. That refrigerator keeps moving. Entry number 21. I spend all my time at the garbage dump now. It's my element. It's a refrigerator. It's empty. But it keeps moving. That is definitely not an empty refrigerator. This refrigerator seems to contain samples of some kind. Still... Oh, okay. That one was alive. But the other one wasn't, apparently. Ah. It's so... Cold. Okay. Hello, amalgamate. Joke? Her expression starts to shift. Haha, I remember, or something. It's so cold. I didn't get to see what you said because I skipped it too fast by accident. It's so funny, I can't stop. Tears run down my face. What? You didn't do that? Snowy. Hmm. It's so cold. Thank you. That is the wimpiest attack I have ever seen. She's completely calmed down. I won! Okay, I got the blue key. Now I just need to remember where the blue receiver was. Curtain. I can't remember all. Are these all. Are all these little notes things like one word that I'm supposed to remember for the future? Still empty? It's moving. I don't understand. Alright, if you say so. Okay, I have the blue one, and the blue one's in the other end of the world. So let me go there, and then hopefully I'll get the whatchamacallit for the yellow one. I'll save all in here. This is such a puzzling power room to get into. Why do people in games make their doors like ridiculously complexly powerful or secure? Now where do I get the yellow thing? Apparently not from the yellow flowers, that's for sure. Is this where I get the yellow one from? Do I just need to wait for this thing to tuck me in, and then something's gonna happen if I wait long enough, or what? Alright. Nothing appears to have happened. Interesting. So where is this last switch thing? Do I need to check out all the rest of the beds that I haven't checked out? I knew it! And now we can go through here. Oh dear. What are these creatures? I can't run from them. It's not letting me move. Hey, stop! I got you guys some food, okay? Sorry about that. They get kind of sassy when they don't get fed on time. I think they smelled the potato chips you had, and anyway. The power went out, and I've been trying to turn it back on. But it seems like you were one step ahead of me. This was probably just a big inconvenience for you, but I appreciate that you came here to back me up. As I said, I was afraid I might not come back. But that's not because of these guys or anything. I was just worried I would be too afraid to tell the truth, that I might run away or do something cowardly. Aww. I suppose I owe you an explanation. As you probably know, Asgore asked me to study the nature of souls. During my research, I isolated a power I called Determination. I injected it into dying monsters so their souls would last after death, but the experiment failed. You see, unlike humans, monsters' bodies don't have enough physical matter to take these concentrations of determination. Their bodies started to melt and lose what physicality they had. Pretty soon, all the test subjects had melted together into those. Seeing them like this, I knew. I couldn't tell their families about it. I couldn't tell anyone about it. No matter how much everyone was asking me. And I was too afraid to do any more work, knowing everything I'd done so far had been such a horrific failure. But now I've changed all my mind about all this. I'm going to tell everyone what I've done. It's going to be hard. Being honest. Believing in myself. I'm sure there will be times where I'll struggle. I'm sure there will be times where I screw up again. But knowing deep down that I have friends to fall back on, I know it'll be a lot easier to stand on my own. Thank you. Come on, guys. It's time for everyone to go home. Entry number 8. I've chosen a candidate. I haven't told Asgore yet because I want to surprise him with it. In the center of his garden, there's something special. The first golden flower that grew before all the others. The flower from the outside world. It appeared just before the queen left. I wonder, what happens when something without a soul gains the will to live? Flowey. That's what happens. Entry number 18. The flower's gone. Oh. Great. Hello, phone.
It's a voice you have never heard before. Malibu, are you there? It's been a long time, hasn't it? But you've done well. Thanks to you, everything has fallen into place. Malibu, see you soon. What? What is happening? Whoa. Hey now. What just happened? I cannot go down. The drawer is jammed shut with vines. How did I even get out of it? Okay, there's no place to save. I don't know what's going on. Okay, that's an option. Where does it go? Oh. Hello? I don't know what's going on here. There's no save points. I have no way to save, so I don't know what's happening here. It's a throne. Smaller throne covered by a white sheet. There's nothing here. Now there's a save point. I had no other option. This is the only place I had to be. This is the barrier. This is what keeps us all trapped underground. If by chance you have any unfinished business, please do what you must. I don't really have any way to go back. I didn't have anything that I could do, so I guess this is all I can do. I see. This is it then. He looks so nice. Ready? No, not really. A strange light fills the room. Twilight is shining through the barrier. It seems your journey is finally over. You're filled with determination. Human, it was nice to meet you. Goodbye. Toriel? Toriel! What a miserable creature, torturing such a poor, innocent youth. Do not be afraid, my child. It is I, Toriel, your friend and guardian. At first, I thought I would let you make your journey alone, but I could not stop worrying about you. Your adventure must have been so treacherous, and ultimately, it would burden you with such a horrible choice. To leave this place, you would have to take the life of another person. You would have to defeat Asgore. However, I realize, I cannot allow that. It is not right to sacrifice someone simply to let someone leave here. Is that not what I've been trying to prevent this whole time? So, for now, let us suspend this battle. As terrible as Asgore is, he deserves mercy too. Tori, you came back. Do not Tori me, dreamer. You pathetic whelp. If you really wanted to free our kind, you could have gone through the barrier after you got one soul. Taken 6 souls from the humans, then come back and freed everyone peacefully. But instead, you made everyone live in despair, because you would rather wait here, meekly hoping another human never comes. Tori, you're right. I am a miserable creature. But do you think we can at least be friends again? No, Asgore.
Nah, Asgore, human. Nobody fight each other. Everyone's gonna make friends, or else I'll...
Hello, I am Toriel. Are you the human's friend? It is nice to meet you.
Yeah? Nice to meet you. Hey, Asgore, is that your ex? Jeez, that's rough, buddy. Hey, nobody hurt each other.
Oh, are you another friend? I am Toriel. Hello.
Hi?
There's two of them?
Huh? Hey, nobody fight anyone! If anyone fights anyone, then I'll be forced to ask Undyne for help!
Hello.
Oh, hello, your majesty.
Psst, hey, human. Did Asgore shave?
And clone himself?
Hey guys, what's up?
That voice. Hello, I think we may know each other?
Oh hey, I recognize your voice too.
I am Toriel. So nice to meet you.
The name says, and same.
Oh, wait, then. This must be your brother, Papyrus. Greetings, Papyrus. It is so nice to finally meet you. Your brother has told me so much about you.
Wowee! I can't believe Asgore's clone knows who I am! This is the best day of my life!
Hey, Papyrus. What does a skeleton tile his roof with?
Snowproof roof tiles?
No, silly. A skeleton tiles his roof with shingles!
I changed my mind! This is the worst day of my life!
Come on, Asgore, it's gonna be okay. There are plenty of fish in the sea.
Yeah, Asgore, Undyne's totally right about the fish thing. Sometimes you just gotta, stop going after furry boss monsters and, just get to know a really cute fish.
Huh?
It's a metaphor. Well, I think it's a good analogy.
Oh my gosh, will you two just smirch already? The audience is dying for some romantic action.
Hey, shut up!
Man, the nerve of that guy. Right, Alfies?
Alfies? No. He's right. Let's...
Well, what? Wow. Wow.
Wait! Not in front of the human!
Right. Sorry, I got a little carried away there. Oh, wow.
My child, it seems as you must stay here for a while. But looking at all the great friends you have made, I think you will be happy here.
Hey, that reminds me. Papyrus, you called everyone here, right? Well, besides, her. Anyway, if I got here before you, how did you know how to call everyone?
Let's just say a tiny flower helped me.
A tiny flower? Oh no, not again. What are you... Flowey, why?
You idiots. While you guys were having your little powwow, I took the human souls. And now, not only are those under my power, but all your friend's souls are gonna be mine too.
And you know what the best part is? It's all your fault. It's all because you made them love you. All the time you spent listening to them, encouraging them, caring about them. Without that, they wouldn't have come here. And now, with their souls and the humans together, I will achieve my real form.
Huh? Why am I still doing this?
Don't you get it? This is all just a game. If you leave the underground satisfied, you'll win the game. If you win, you won't want to play with me anymore. And what would I do then?
But this game between us will never end. I'll hold victory in front of you just within your reach, and then tear it away just before you grasp it. Over and over and over. Listen, if you do defeat me, I'll give you your happy ending. I'll bring your friends back. I'll destroy the barrier. Everyone will finally be satisfied, but that won't happen. I'll keep you here no matter what.
Oh no. I cannot move. Even if it means killing you 1,000,000 times. I can't do anything.
What?
Do not be afraid, my child. No matter what happens, we will always be there to protect you.
That's right, human. You can win. Just do what I would do. Believe in you.
Hey, human. If you got past me, you can do anything. So don't worry. We're with you all the way.
Huh? You haven't beaten this guy yet? Come on, this weirdo's got nothing on you.
Well, I'm not doing your thing.
Technically, it's impossible for you to beat him, but somehow I know you can do it.
Human, for the future of humans and monsters, you have to stay determined.
La la la, we're with you too.
Wow, what is happening? What in the world? Look at Flower's face.
Urgh, no! Unbelievable! This can't be happening.
This is exciting. I'm really happy about this. Wait, let me get out of the way so you can see the little creature behind me.
You! You!
Idiot. I can't believe you're all so stupid.
All of your souls are mine!
You're a flower, what are you gonna do? What is going on? Oh my goodness, what's happening? Is that their son? What is happening? Hello? Finally. I was so tired of being a flower. Huh?
Howdy. Malibu, are you there? It's me, your best friend.
Azrael, dreamer. It's the end. Dream? Hope? I held on to your hopes. I reduced how much damage. I'll take this turn. It's the end. What is happening? I think about why I'm here now. I can feel the empty space in my inventory get smaller and smaller. Oh, what is happening? Oh my goodness. Oh, what the heck? Oh, wow. I'm surprised I didn't die. You know, I don't care about destroying this world anymore. Ah! After I defeat you and gain total control over the timeline, I just want to reset everything. I am lucky that I did not die. All your progress, everyone's memories, I'll bring them all back to zero. Azrael readies star blazing. Last dream? Through determination, the dream became true. My HP was maxed out. Then we can do everything all over again. Oh gosh, it's so hard to avoid with so much going on. I can't even tell what's happening. My items fill up with dreams. And you know what the best part of all this is? You'll do it. I'll do it all over again, you mean? Ah, what is happening? Oh, seriously? But it refused. I held on to my hopes. I reduced how much damage I'll take this turn. That is, if I take any at all. I don't know what's happening, but the music is very helpful and cool. This is such a cool game. I don't know what's going on anymore, but it's very fun. Missed me this time, buddy. And then you'll lose to me again. Chaos Buster. And again. Missed. Shocker Breaker 2. And again. Oh gosh. What is happening? Oh man. Because you want a happy ending. I would love a happy ending. But I might still play and get the bad ending at some other point in the future. Azrael calls on Chaos Slicer. Because you love your friends. Missed. Haha. Ready's Chaos Blaster. Because you never give up. Whew. Oh man, it's a good thing that missed me. Whew. Even though I apparently can't die. Isn't that delicious? Your determination, the power that lets you get this far. It's gonna be your downfall. Now, enough messing around. It's time to purge this timeline once and for all. What is happening? Even after that attack, you're still standing in my way? Wow, you really are something special. But you don't get cocky. Up till now, I've only been using a fraction of my real power. Let's see what good your determination is against this. Huh? Azra blocks the way. I've already been fighting him for a long time. Can't move your body. Ha! Behold my true power. I can feel it. Every time you die, your grip on this world slips away. Every time you die, your friends forget you a little more. Your life will end here in a world where no one remembers you.
Ah!
The whole world is ending. Can't move my body. Still, you're hanging on? That's fine. In a few moments, you'll forget everything, too. That attitude will serve you well in your next life. Ow, the whole world is ending. Haha. Still? Come on, show me what good your determination is now. I'm still holding on. I can't do anything else besides act. Nothing happened. You struggle, nothing happened. You tried to reach your save file. Nothing happened. You tried again to reach your save file. Nothing happened. Seems saving the game really is impossible. But maybe, with what little power you have, you can save something else. Save. Any of them, all of them. Toriel, first. I reached out to Azriel's soul and called out to your friends. They're in there somewhere, aren't they? Within the depths of Azriel's soul, something resonating. The lost souls appeared. What am I supposed to... What? Why am I gonna... I didn't mean to fight them, if that's what I was... I hug the lost soul and tell them that you're going to see them again. Something about this is familiar to her. No one will leave again. This is my duty. The lost souls stand there. I refuse to fight. Something about this is so familiar to her. The lost souls stand there. Huh? She faintly recalls hearing this before. No one will leave again. This is my duty. The lost souls stand there. Suddenly, her memories are flooding back. Seeing her remember you, the male soul tried hard to remember you too. Your fate is up to you now. You are our future. I feel something faintly resonating within Azriel. Sans. Act.
I must capture a human!
Just give up, I did. The lost soul stand there. Puzzle. I asked the lost soul for help with the puzzle. He doesn't know why, but he really wants to help you.
Then everyone will!
Why even try? This is certainly a finale, alright. Really get me in the feels, even though I don't even know what's going on. I mean, I kind of know what's going on. I mean, I know what's going on, it's just... Wow. The Lost Soul stand there. Recipe. I asked the Lost Soul to cook something for you. The Lost Soul's trying to hide its joy. You'll never see him again. Lost Soul stand there. Last option, insult. I insulted the lost soul. Suddenly, its memories are flooding back. Seeing how nicely you treated its brother, the other lost soul remembers too.
No, wait, you're my friend! I could never capture you!
Nah, I'm rooting for you, kid.
All humans will die!
The lost soul stands there. I asked the lost soul to teach me how to cook. She doesn't know why, but she kinda wants to teach me how. You're our real enemy. The lost soul stands there. Smile. Big smile, like you remember she likes to do. Suddenly, the memories are flooding back. Well, some humans are okay, I guess. Alfies. Within the depths of Azriel's soul, something is resonating. The lost souls appeared. No! What did... I did not mean to fight it. You hate me, don't you? No, I do not. Oh, how do I do this again? Oops. Ah. I've got to keep flying. No, you don't. The lost soul stands there. Call. I call the lost soul on the phone. She starts to sweat. She doesn't know why, but all this seems very familiar. All I do is hurt people. No, you're awesome. You have saved lots of people. The lost soul stands there. Nerd out. I asked the lost soul what her favorite cartoon is. Suddenly the memories are flooding back. No, that's not true. My friends like me, and I like you too. You feel your friends' souls resonating within Azrael. Save someone else. Strangely, as your friends remembered you, something else began resonating within the soul, stronger and stronger. It seems that there's still one last person that needs to be saved. But who?
Me?
Suddenly, you realize. You reach out and call their name.
Huh? What are you doing?
Azrael? Flowey? Malibu? You feel your friends' souls resonating within Azrael.
What did you do? What's this feeling? What's happening to me? No, no, I don't need anyone.
I'm not even worried. Like, this is a crazy attack? But what happened?
Stop it! Get away from me! Do you hear me? I'll tear you apart!
Your attack is not as strong as the last one was. Malibu, do you know why I'm doing this? Why I keep fighting to keep you around? It's because you like me? You miss me? I'm doing this because you're special, Malibu. You're the only one that understands me. You're the only one who's any fun to play with anymore. Your attacks are running away from me. You don't want to hurt me anymore. No, that's not just it. I am doing this because I care about you, Malibu. I care about you more than anybody else. I'm not ready for this to end. I'm not ready for you to leave. I'm not ready to say goodbye to someone like you again. So please, stop doing this. And just let me win! Stop it! I can't move. Stop it now! It's such a low number, but it's still there. Malibu. I'm so alone. Malibu, I'm going to play this more even after this game. I'm so afraid, Malibu. Malibu, I... I'm so sorry. I always was a crybaby, wasn't I, Malibu? I know. You're not actually Malibu, are you? Malibu's been gone for a long time. What? What is your name? Frisk? That's a nice name. Frisk. I haven't felt like this for a long time. As a flower, I was soulless. I lacked the power to love other people. However, with everyone's souls inside me, I not only have my own compassion back, but I can feel every other monster's as well. They all care about each other so much. And they care about you too, Frisk. I wish I could tell you how everyone feels about you. Papyrus, Sans, Undyne, Alphys, Toriel. Monsters are weird. Even though they barely know you, it feels like they all really love you. Frisk, I understand if you can't forgive me. I understand if you hate me. I acted so strange and horrible. I hurt you, I hurt so many people. Friends, family, bystanders. There's no excuse for what I've done. Of course. What? Frisk, come on. You're gonna make me cry again. Besides, even if you do forgive me, I can't keep these souls inside me. The least I can do is return them. But first, there's something I have to do. Right now, I can feel everyone's hearts beating as one. They're all burning with the same desire. With everyone's power, with everyone's determination, it's time for monsters to finally go free. Oh my. What is happening? The barrier was destroyed. Frisk, I have to go now. Without the power of everyone's souls, I can't keep maintaining this form. In a little while, I'll turn back into a flower. I'll stop being myself. I'll stop being able to feel love again. So, Frisk, it's best if you just forget about me, okay? Just go be with the people who love you. It's so sad. I don't understand all of this, but I don't want to let go. I know the feeling, buddy. Frisk, you're gonna do a great job, okay? No matter what you do, everyone will be there for you, okay? Man, I almost don't want to do the bad ending now, like the genocide route. Killing everybody in a different game. I don't want to do that. It's so sad. Because all these people, they feel real now. This is a really well done game. Well, my time's running out. Goodbye. It's just face on the back of his head. By the way, Frisk, take care of Mom and Dad for me, okay? Okie doke. Frisk, this is all just a bad dream. Please wake up. What happened?
Oh, you are awake. Thank goodness.
We were so worried. It felt like you were out forever. Yeah, any longer and I would have freaked out. Tell us next time you decide to take a nap, okay? Yeah, you made Papyrus cry like a baby.
What? I didn't cry. I don't cry. I just caught something in my eye. My skeletal eye socket.
What did you catch?
Tears!
No, no. The important part is that Frisk is all right. Here, Frisk. Why not drink some tea? It'll make you feel better.
How about we give him space first? They must be very exhausted. Though from what, I am not certain. Frisk, we do not remember exactly what happened. There was a flower, and then everything went white. But now the barrier is gone. When you are ready, we will all return to the surface. It seems the door to the east will lead us there now. But before then, perhaps you might want to take a walk? You can say goodbye to all of your wonderful friends.
Do as you wish. We will wait for you here.
So the door to the east. That way. No. Well. That way. That way for you guys, but... never mind. So I can say goodbye to people. Save just in case. I don't really have anyone to say goodbye to. Oh well, these guys, obviously.
Hello, Frisk. Alfie's upgraded my phone. I am having a lot of fun with the texting feature. Sans, check out this one.
Oh man, Tori. That's brutal.
I can't believe the Queen has returned! And also that she's a huge dork! You two are 2 feet away from each other! Why are you texting?
Worry not, Papyrus. We are texting for a good reason.
Why is that?
Well, because we're huge dorks.
Sans, please do not say that. You are not a dork. You are more of a bonehead.
Haha, wow. Those puns are even less funny coming from her.
Then why are you smiling?
It's a pretty smile.
Frisk, Tori was telling me how she made butterscotch pie for you.
Oh, I should bake it for everyone sometime.
Oh, that sounds really good.
Cooking? Can I help?
Wait a second. Can I help too?
Certainly. It would be fun to cook together.
On second thought, maybe I'll order a pizza. Oh, man. So, Asgore.
How about making me a member of the Royal Guard?
Well, Papyrus, now that the war is over, we might not need the Royal Guard after all.
What? Then what was the point of the human's quest? They journeyed all that way, and I'm still not a member of the Royal Guard? Truly, this is the worst possible ending.
So, Alfies, what do you want me to do now that we're all free? We have the whole world to explore now. Well, of course I'm going to go out and... No, I should be honest. I'm going to stay inside and watch anime like a total loser.
That's the spirit! Everyone, a celebration to being losers!
Huzzah! Papyrus has the right idea. Losing to Frisk is the best thing that ever happened to me. So I'm glad that we... Huh? What is it, Asgore? What's an... anime?
Oh my god. Frisk, please, help me explain what anime is to ask.
You see, it's like a cartoon, but... with swords. So it's like a cartoon, but with swords? Golly, that sounds neato. Where is this? Where can I see the anime? Hold on, I think I have some on my phone. Here, look at this. Oh, that's the wrong... Oh, never mind. Golly, were those two robots... Boy, technology sure is something, huh? Yeah, it sure is.
Oh, man. Psst, Frisk. You've gotta tell me. Do you think Asgore and Toriel are... ever gonna get back together? I hope so. They're a good couple.
Yeah. That's what I hope, too. Just think about how cute they must have been together. It's quickly becoming my number one ship of all time. Tori and Gori. My old boss and his ex-wife. That sounds a lot less cool all of a sudden. On second thought, maybe I won't write fanfics of real people. I mean, isn't real life already the greatest fanfiction of all? Don't tell anyone I said that, because I'm going to post it online. I sure am excited to finally use the human internet. I bet they have all sorts of things Undyne and I can watch. Oh man, we're going to be able to watch anime online? Of course, Undyne. What do you think we've been fighting for all along? Yeah, what do you... Whoops. Jinx, I knew you were going to make that joke.
Wait, Alfies, I didn't know you knew Sans.
Well, I... Doesn't everybody?
Who the heck is Sans? Who the
Toriel?
Hey Frisk, why don't you go look for Metaton? He was here for a while too, but he said he had to go somewhere. There are so many things to... Howdy, Frisk.
Sorry about almost trying to take your soul. I feel very bad about it. I hope we can still be pals.
Hey, don't worry about it, Asgore. I think everybody's tried to kill Frisk at least once.
Oh, I see. In that case, I'm not sorry, Frisk.
Asgore, that's not what I meant.
Frisk, I just realized. Now that we aren't fighting each other, I can finally ask you, would you like a cup of tea?
Would you like a cup of tea?
Sure.
Oh, well. Actually, the cup I had is cold now, so you shouldn't have it. But I am so happy you said yes. As soon as I can, I will make some more for you. Then we can be great pals.
Oh, Frisk, if you're not busy, on nice days, you should walk around and have a good time. That's important.
Hey, Alfies! Alfies! Do you think we can watch something with fighting next?
Oh, and then something with princesses?
Or fighting princesses?
I'll see if I can manage to find anything like that, Undyne.
Yay!
Hey, Frisk, why don't you go say hi to Nabsabluk?
Oh, and tell him I said hi, too.
It seems like I actually botched your request, Frisk. But I, the Great Papyrus, will always be your friend.
No matter how hard you try to get rid of him.
Hey! That's true. Frisk, why don't you take a walk around?
Frisk, why don't you fly? It's faster. Well.
Yeah, Frisk, why don't you fly?
Flying sounds a little dangerous.
But they can't fly. Not with that attitude.
Fix, take a hike. Hiking is good for your bones.
Sorry, I don't have time to talk, Frisk. I'm supposed to be working right now.
But you aren't working!
I know, and it's taking all my concentration.
Frisk, do not feel left out. I have been writing messages to you as well. You still have my phone number after all this time, do you not?
I do. Should I call her?
Frisk, how about you go look around before we all go? Seeing how many good friends you've made here, I am almost certain you have made some more.
Let's call. Notice you received a text from from what's-her-face, Toriel.
Dear Frisk, Sans and Alfies are teaching me how to text. I am learning so much. For example, do you know what a smiley is? Please look at this. Now turn your head to the left. It is a picture of me smiling at you. Can you see it? LOL. That stands for lots of laughter. Sincerely, Toriel. That's all for now. Maybe in the next room, you will receive another.
Alright, I'm gonna go talk to some people. I wonder what those cat people are gonna be doing now that there's no more destruction of humanity.
Howdy, EJ from the future here. If you're not interested in watching about 17 minutes of me wandering around the underground and talking to all these different people that I've made friends with over the period of time for playing the game, you can skip ahead to the exactly 2-hour mark. Walking around for a long period of time and talking to all these people just to see what they had to say, it kind of killed the mood because it was such a long period of time. It was still interesting, but like it took so long that it kind of like killed the final awesome ending mood. So if you want to just skip ahead, you can go ahead and go to the 2-hour mark and see the finale to the series. Or you can watch if you're curious about what everyone has to say. Your choice.
So we're free, huh?
Metaton told us as much. Then he told me, don't think that means you're getting out of work early.
Ah, my boss. I love that guy. And by that I mean I hate him so much. Well, we're all gonna be free, so I'll never see them again, at least. Don't tell anyone this, little buddy, because they'll make fun of me. But I feel like I played a hand in everyone getting free somehow. Even if it was just working at this awful job. I think I did something. I don't know if it's true, but I'll believe it anyway. Well, I did buy some things from you, so. Little buddy, there's a brand new world out there waiting for us. I'm sure with my, qualifications, it won't be long before I'm a famous movie star. Or maybe I'll just end up flipping burgers again. But it's as I say, nowhere to go but up. Literally, in this case.
Hi, guys. Are you guys on your way out? Guess I'll catch up with you later.
As a slime, I'm overjoyed. Good news, the elevator started working again, but now it's been so busy we still haven't gotten a chance to ride it.
Room service never came, aw. Sorry, I would have come. I just didn't have the right stuff. He's trying so hard to clean up the but he's sliming it up himself. Hello, who are you? Now we can live life without reservations. So if we're leaving, will my job? I just got a raise. Well, at least every apple has its core. The surface world, really? Maybe I'll be able to go 2 feet without running into a puzzle. Hello. Oh, we're all free? Oh, I guess I can stop licking this fecus, but I don't want to look like I messed up, so I'll keep going. I don't know where to find Metaton. So, like, what's up? So, we're, like, totally free now, huh? Yeah, like, totally free. Like, cool. Yeah, like, cool. Yeah, like, millennia of being in prison finally over? Yeah, like, that's pretty chill, I guess. Oh, oops, really? Well, when we said, we were hyped for the destruction of humanity, we were, like, just joking, you know?
Did we say that?
Probably? It's, like, practically our catchphrase. Really? I thought our catchphrase was, Braddy's the best, Catty's the coolest. No. We've, like, literally never said that. Can it be, though? Can it be? Oh, man. Now that we're gonna be free, OMG, we can finally fulfill our dream of having a pet cat. That's, like, your dream, Catty.
But, Braddy, I don't want to have a dream without you in it.
Aw, Catty. And in my dream, you clean up after the cat. Catty! Yeah, I love cats. They're, like, so tasty. So cute. Braddy, no! I'm just kidding. Kind of. Anyway, when was the last time you even saw a cat around here? Oh, just the other day. There was this cute little white cat walking around. It was, like, so clueless looking. I pet it for, like, an hour. Catty? Yeah, Braddy? I think that was, like, a dog. Dogs are just firm cats. Oh, man. I'm so excited to sell an ice cream on the surface. If all humans are like you, I think it'll be a modest success. Undyne told us that the Royal Guard is being disbanded. Like, bummer, I guess we'll have to get used to love and peace. He seems happy. I don't have a clue where I'm going.
What? Do you want a rematch?
Is Metaton in here? I guess I'm not gonna talk to every single person because that would take forever, but I'll go to the most densely populated areas. A few million more pairs of pants left. Let's talk to Crazy Turtle Man.
Haha! I knew you could do it! Okay, I remember clearly now. It was the monthly address at the castle, and the queen was giving her part of the current events. After finishing her update, she moved past the microphone to the king. However, she didn't realize the microphone was still in her hands when she said, "Your turn, Fluffy Buns." The audience burst into laughter. Realizing what she just said, she started laughing too. After a few moments, the king held up his arms. The crowd grew silent. He leaned towards the microphone, expression stern. "Dear citizens, thank you for coming here today. I, King Fluffy Buns, and the rest is history." That is amazing. Is Asgore a goat? Eh? Goat? Actually, that reminds me. Toriel once wore a flower patterned moo-moo. Folks kept saying nice moo-moo to her, but she kept thinking they were calling her a cow. So she never wore it again.
That was the what was the question again? Oh, right. Asgore. He's a real interesting type of monster, the strongest type of all. We call them boss monsters. When they have an offspring, the soul power of the parents flows into the child, causing the child to grow as the parents age. But as Asgore, doesn't have a child. So he's been stuck at the same age, and probably will be forever. Huh? What if the child is a human? What?
Nah, that wouldn't work. So if Asgore is your father, he'll definitely outlive you.
Oh yeah, of course. Toriel was queen and Asgore was the king. It was tragic when she left.
Since everyone knew she was really the brains behind the throne, but it was also just a teensy bit relieving, you know? Those two were really insufferable together, nuzzling noses, being all cute and cuddly in public, embarrassing their children. They were so sweet, it made me sick. Thank goodness those days are over. Undyne, she's really come a long way since she was a little urchin. I used to be a hero myself back in the old days, Gerson the Hammer of Justice. When she was younger, Undyne would follow me around to watch me beat up bad guys. Sometimes she'd even try to help, though most of the time the folks she attacked weren't bad guys. It'd be like the mailman or something like that. Anywho, I appreciated it. Be careful out there, kid.
Let's go to Timmy Village, because the Timmies are cute. I'm trying to figure out where the other waterfall-y place was. I think it's to the left.
Yay.
Whoa! Tamir Nudes! Very good! Whoa! Tamir Nudes! Very good! Yeah! Tams can go free! A pleasing development, no? Whoa! If Tams can go on surface, can see lots of good zooming! Everyone's go free! But Tam! Tam not live! Tam watch egg! Tam will be happily family! Hives!
Mushroom dance, whatever could it mean?
It symbolizes my inner turmoil.
My unbridled happiness. The government told me they are willing to transplant me outside. Why didn't you smile at my dance? It almost feels a little rude. I did smile. Let's talk to the guy in here, or girl, Timmy.
Hi, I'm Timmy.
Us DTMs have deep history. Yeah, go to Tem Shop.
I had the sudden realization I never paid for Temmie's college. I took advantage of her, kind of, but I never actually, gave her money for free to pay for college. And I was like, I forget, was that a reasonable amount of money, like 1,000, or was it like 10,000, something I could never get? But it's 1,000, and I have more than 1,000, so I'm gonna pay for Tem's college and be nice. Buy for 1,000? Yeah.
Wow! That's a lot of months. Can STEM really accept? Okay, STEM, go to college and make you proud.
you left your face behind. What? No, I was graduated.
Tem back from cool leg. Tem learn many things. Tem learn how to make new item.
Yeah.
Hi, welcome to... Oh, you got a new item? 750.
Timmy, armor?
Armor makes battles too easy.
You don't have the muns.
Tem armor so good that any battle become an easy victory.
But Tem thinks if you use the armor's battle wouldn't be a challenge anymore.
But Tem have a solution. Tem will offer a scholarship. If you lose a lot of battles, Tem will lower the price. In fact, price may already be lowers. Whoa! Congratulations!
Well, I beat the whole game without needing your cheaty, super awesome armor, but thank you anyway. I just thought I was gonna be nice to you and finally pay back for you buying all my stuff. Anyway. That's the last thing I wanted to do. I actually had to come back and remember this because I had forgotten it during the actual playthrough, but yeah, that was worth it. Good job, Tim. You graduated. I'm still at college. I wish I could go that fast.
I wish I could teleport around. That would make things easier. Or fly. Or use Sans' magical shortcuts. This game is really well made. I can only imagine how long it took.
What? Undyne says hi? Then tell her I say something cool. Human, I'll never forget when you cheered me on. When I was pretending to sleep, no one had ever seen so much faith in my fake sleep. Also, this is awkward, but what's your name? Everyone seems to know it now, except me. Seems like I've been missing out lately. I was just sitting at home listening to tunes. There was a flash of light outside my window. I saw the snails on the farm disappear. Then I heard a knock at the door. The flash of light wanted to come in. I closed the blinds. Now everyone knows your name except for me. Frisk. Okay, I won't forget it.
There you are, Frisk, darling. Feast your eyes. Dr. Alfie's completed my wonderful new body. Oh, and did you hear? The barrier's open! I can't wait to see the sun! The greatest spotlight of all! Oh yes, I suppose I should thank you too, darling. Before fighting you, I had forgotten how much fun it was to perform with others. So I've been searching for hot talents to fill up my upcoming troupe. So far, Shren's agreed to be my backup singer. And Nabstabluk here will be my sound mixer. The three of us performing together, it really feels overdue, doesn't it?
If I remember correctly, there's only like a scattering, many scatterings of people everywhere else, so the only place I really have left to go to sincerely is Snowden, I think. I guess I could talk to the spiders too, but it doesn't seem like they're as important. This is a very concentrated area of people though, so.
Now we can play monsters and humans with real humans!
When humans play monsters and humans, do they just call it humans and humans? Seems like this is the beginning of a brand new, boundless world.
Aha! This adventurous spirit! I'm like a kid again! And my children are like double children.
Huh. Ice Wolf no longer has to throw ice. Ice Wolf can take a break to buy some pants now. You know have pants? Hey.
Oh, we're free? Finally, I'll be able to stop smiling.
Looks like I won't have to worry about cracking jokes anymore. I was going to say a joke here, but I really don't have one.
It's okay, you don't need to make jokes all the time.
I heard Dr. Alfie's told the king and queen the awful thing she'd done. The king felt so bad that he didn't know. He gave her a big hug. Then the queen fired her. Now we don't have a royal scientist anymore.
That's politics.
Too bad there are no more politics on the surface. Oh, there are plenty of politics. Trump and Hillary. Lesser of two evils. Yo, what's up? I've been kinda doing some thinking. Maybe Undyne isn't actually as cool as we thought. She's just kinda mean. But yo, I found something way cooler. Dude. It'll be nice to know, show humans our presence under the tree tradition. They'll probably be weirded out by it. That kid over there told me that it's weird that I have a pet bunny. First, there'd be nothing weird about it. It's cute. Second,
what?
It's normal to walk your younger brother on a leash, right? Is anyone else weirded out by those giant shambling amalgamates, or... Wait, are they home? Those amalgamate things? Hello, traveler. How can I help you? What happened? I mean, it happened to you, right? There was a strange flash of white light, then I felt my body being pulled into something. Then suddenly everything was back to normal. I heard that it was all because of a human came through here. A human? I can hardly believe it. Well, if they decided to stop in, I'd be sure to give them a hero's welcome. Did you hear? The ruins have been opened up, and get this, they were opened from the inside. Apparently the queen had been staying inside there for God knows how long. Pretty unbelievable, huh? Well, I suppose I'll move my store to the overworld. Haven't planned much more than that, I'm afraid. Hello, sorry, no time for a nap. Snowden is shutting down so we can all go to the surface. Mom says that we can go to the surface world now. What's so great about that anyway? I don't want to move. Welcome to the library. This is the last day we'll be open, so make as much noise as you want. Oh my, there's so much news to report. I don't know where to begin. How about this headline? Monsters go free from the underground.
Nah, that doesn't have enough pizzazz.
How about top 10 monsters you won't believe got freed from the underground? No, please don't go the clickbait route. This will be our newspaper's last issue. Why don't we just put a big the end on the front and call it a day? The greatest struggle of my life is over. I just solved today's crossword. Hey, buddy.
Now that our parents are the same entity, does that mean I'm married to my sister?
What?
Wait, we're dogs. That stuff's normal.
What?
Oh. Oh.
All of our parents have been combined into one horrible being. That's okay, though. It's really brought our families together. Oh. Having an amorphous, shambling family member is great. They're always moving, so I can see them 100% of the time.
Alright. I think that's everyone to talk to around here. I can't remember if they said to talk to anybody else. So I think that's it. Man, I kind of don't like the fact that there's all this walking around and talking to those people, because it kind of changed the mood. It slowed down the pacing. I was like getting emotional with the whole final battle, not being able to die and having everything be awesome. And then it was like talking at the end, and then I was going to go to the end, and I was like, oh, let's go talk to other people first. I don't know. The talking to other people first kind of like slowed down the mood. Especially because I had to walk to all those places instead of like having them all lined up, all the monsters that I had could talk to. I'm so close to the end now of a full pacifist run. I never thought I'd get to see the day. I don't know how. I don't really want to do a genocide run now. I did a pacifist run, and I wanted to be like the full completionist, like doing everything that could possibly be done for a game, because it's such a cool thing. But now it's like, man, can I even bring myself to cause pain to all these characters that I like? I don't know. It's sad. I don't know if I will. We'll see. I mean, I guess I will just for the sake of it, but it might make me really sad, and I really don't want to. Did I go the wrong way? I think I might have missed an elevator or something. Now we're at the end. Alright. The end. Here we go. Ah! This is such a cool game. If you leave here, your adventure will really be over. Your friends will follow you out of the underground. I'm ready.
The surface. Oh my.
Isn't it beautiful, everyone?
Wow, it's even better than on TV. Way better. Better than I ever imagined. Frisk, you live with this? The sunlight is so nice, and the air is so fresh. I really feel alive.
Hey, Sans! What's that giant ball?
We call that the sun, my friend.
That's the sun? Wowee! I can't believe I'm finally meeting the sun!
I could stand here and watch this for hours.
Yes, it is beautiful, is it not? But we should really think about what comes next.
Oh, right. Everyone, this is the beginning of a bright new future. An era of peace between humans and monsters. Frisk, I have something to ask of you. Will you act as our ambassador to the humans?
Of course. I gotta let them know that monsters are good people instead of freaking them all out.
Yeah, Frisk will be the best ambassador. And I, the Great Papyrus, will be the best mascot. I'll go make a good first impression.
Oh boy.
Welp. Someone's gotta keep him from getting into trouble. See you guys.
Alright, you just went the opposite way. Are you gonna take another magical shortcut? Man, do I have to go do everything?
Papyrus, wait!
Hey, Undyne, wait up!
Whoops.
What whoops?
Should I do something?
Well, gotta go.
It seems that everyone is quite eager to set off. Frisk, you came from this world, right? So you must have a place to return to, do you not? What will you do now?
I I'd like to stay with them. I don't really know my backstory, so I'll just stay with them.
What? Frisk, you really are a funny child.
Maybe I'm an orphan.
If you had said that earlier, none of this would have happened. It is a good thing you took so long to change your mind. Well, I suppose, if you really do not have any other place to go, I will do my best to take care of you for as long as you need. All right? Now, come along. Everyone is waiting for us.
What? It's so heartwarming. I don't even... Professional frog. Braver every day. Look by Temmie. Vegetoid by Toby and Temmie. Migos by Toby. Casually enjoys life. Nabstab look. Whoa. Ha! Papyrus in a car. Oh yeah, he said he wanted to be in a car. Sands by Toby. So this is the credits. That was cool. Still looking for laughs, thinking about a tat. Guy Fraud. Doggo. Nine. What just happened? She's breaking the ground. There was so much effort put into this. This is so funny. Temmie. Mataton! He's got his old body. Transformation? I'm just gonna let the credits play all the way through. Encouraging space heater. I need one of those. I'm always cold. And often in need of encouragement because I have a very crazy life. Royal guards, use your imagination. There are so many gay couples in this. It's weird. Like the guards, and then Undyne and Alphys, and then what else? I forget. I know I was like realizing that earlier, but I forgot. There was like so many. I think there were more of that kind than like. Normal traditional couples, which is weird. Amalgamates. Living with their families. Oof. Creepy. Ha! That's funny. Asgore. Making a papyrus face. Oh, they got back together. Yay! That's nice. I love happy endings. Aw, why did it fade again? It looked better when it was in color. It would have been better if it faded from gray to, or brown to colors. Ha, you're gonna reset the save file now. It's okay, everything's already over. Did you really think it was over? Just kidding. I mean, we haven't even done this special thanks yet. Ready? Let's end all this for good. Special thanks. Oh gosh. Oh man. Why is this a challenge? Okay. How could I possibly avoid all this? Oh, there's no way I could avoid all this. I can do this part. Oh no! It's fast. Ah! Panic. Wow, there are a lot of people that works on this. I thought it was just one guy. Unless this is almost the same names repeating. Ah! Ah! Oh my gosh. No. It's so hard to. I think online it said that there was a. Whatchamacallit? There was like a. That secret door that I found with the mushrooms and everything. That secret door in Snowden can only be opened if you somehow avoid getting hit by any of the names in the final credits. And that seems pretty much impossible. Touch credits. Huh. Whew.
Hello, Toriel.
She's so nice. I don't know what else to say. I have no input. That was great. That was probably... I'm trying to think. That's probably one of my favorite games. Like, maybe my... Like, narrative-wise, I think that's probably my favorite game ever. Mechanics-wise, it was interesting as well. I can't really compare it to something like Minecraft, which is also a game I like, because like Minecraft is, it doesn't have any narrative. It's very different. It accomplishes different things. So this is like, I don't know. I really like this game though. It's really good. Random dog. Hello, random dog. Well, that was amazing. What happens if I open it again? Is it going to be a whole new game? Hi! Seems as if everyone is perfectly happy. Monsters have returned to the surface. Peace and prosperity will rule across the land. Take a deep breath. There's nothing left to worry about, except for the fact that you're going to take it all away and be all evil again. Well, there is one thing. One last threat. One being with the power to erase everything. Everything... everyone's worked so hard for. You know who I'm talking about, don't you? That's right, it's me. I'm talking about me. You still have the power to reset everything. Toriel, Sans, Asgore, Alphys, Papyrus, Undyne. If you so choose, everyone will be ripped from this timeline and sent back before all this ever happened. Nobody will remember anything. You'll be able to do whatever you want. That power? I know that power. That's the power you were fighting to stop, wasn't it? The power that I wanted to use. But now, the idea of resetting everything? I don't think I could do it all again. Not after that. So please, just let them go. Let Frisk be happy. Let Frisk live their life. But if I can't change your mind, if you do end up erasing everything, you have to erase my memories too. I'm sorry. You've probably heard this 100 times already, haven't you? Well, that's all. See you later, Malibu. True reset. You know what? For now, I'm gonna leave it as it is. Let everyone be happy. I'm not gonna reset it, just gonna quit. Thank you all very much for watching, and I will see you guys all later. I need to process this. It is 1 a.m. I stayed up way too long playing this. It was so good though. I'm dying. I don't even know. I haven't had a game that, like, actually make me feel emotions like that. I've only had, like, one game ever. In my memory, I can only ever remember, like, one of the game that's done that, and I can't remember what it is right now, because it was a long time ago. So this is, like, this is a good game. Anyway, I'm going to stop geeking out and trying to psychoanalyze it and game designify it and learn from it and everything. I'm just gonna, yeah, I don't know. Thank you all very much for watching, and I'll see you guys all later. Bye bye. Thanks so much for sticking with me for the whole adventure, if you did, because it was, oh man, I know you could have watched anyone, any number of people play this game, but you chose to stick with me, and that's pretty cool, because like it was an 8-10 hour game, however long it was. It was so fun. I'm glad I could share this experience with you guys. Anyway, I'm going to stop. I keep saying that I'm going to stop, but I keep rambling on and on. I'm just, thank you all for watching. See you guys later. Bye.